Very good afternoon to one and all present in this virtual gathering number 23. I wish you all a very happy Dasahara, and I hope that you all are safe, you all are staying happy wherever you are. Today's topic we have to discuss, which we have already decided, that is how to record video, how to add background, and also how to publish it on different forums, whether it is social media or in offline mode. So this is our choice that where we are going to publish it, and accordingly we will be talking about that, what are the different methods available, or what are the different tools or software, hardware we have to use so that we can use it for our education or for our personal purpose. So first, I again wish you all a very happy Dasahara, and I request all of you to please stay safe, stay happy, and take care of your family, because they are our real asset. And now let's move to the topic which we have decided. And I'm going to share my screen so that I will be able to drag your attention towards what the content I'm going to give you today, and hope I will be able to demonstrate, I'll be able to give you enough material which will be beneficial for your purpose. So as you can see that the topic is record, edit, and add background to a video. And in this webinar, we are going to discuss the same. My small introduction includes working as an assistant librarian in NIT Rourkela. And you can see later also this video will be available on YouTube. The outline of the today's video is what is the purpose you are going to record a video? The main and most important thing, that what is the purpose of my video, whether I'm going to share it in offline mode or I'm going to share it in online mode. So accordingly, you have to choose the software. If I have to deliver the content online, so in that case, I'll be using any online platform, and I will be sharing my content through different software or virtual conferencing software or whatever the medium I choose. So especially when we talk about the webinar, these days we are facing, we are attending a lot of webinars due to the problem we are facing due to the COVID and pandemic. So we are bound to be in a physical boundary or in a restriction where we are not supposed to go and attend in the physical environment. So all the throughout the world, people, they have come forward and they are conducting online webinar, seminar, conferences, and workshop events. So if you are going to go with webinar or the video only to share in the online mode, so for that we will be talking the different software. In the offline mode also, I will let you know that how you can record the video, how you can edit it, how you can how you can add some more content, and how you can add the background so that when you publish it, it looks good. And especially when we see that you might have seen the different online educational platform like edX and a Swayam portal, you can see, and other so many are there where they record the video, they edit it properly, and if there is any missing content, they add also, they add the text, they add the so many content so that it is it does not miss anything. And especially the educational tutorial, they ensure that all the multimedia, the sound quality, the video quality, the content, exercise, everything is properly mixed, and then they release the video. So basically the professional video, when they release or they upload, so they ensure that these videos are thrown on the internet platform with all you can say relevant material, because people they keep checking for the latest update, and if it is not updated, so in that case they may disappoint. So we have to first decide what is my purpose of video, what content I am going to just cover in this video. See, this is my personal opinion. I have been making a video for a YouTube channel, Librarian Guy, where my main focus always I try to choose that topic which may be beneficial for my friends, which may be beneficial for new users. And if I start talking the things which is not relevant, obviously you will lose the interest. Obviously, you will not take much interest to see the whole video. And also it will bore you. It you will not like because you may feel irritated why these many things are discussed unnecessarily. So in that situation, if you are going to make any video, you have to ensure that this video is going to cover this much content. And if you are going online, suppose you're going to deliver any content, so you have to ensure that all the content, either in the presentation form or you have summarized in your mind, you have mapped properly the all the outline and for the content related to it, so that when you speak, you should not deviate from your main topic. So you need to decide what is the content of my video. So that will help a lot to throw the content in a proper way. And then after that, we need to suppose we are going to discuss about the software and this offline video. So we need to think that which software is going to be useful for editing and recording. I will be discussing this event. And what are the hardware, what are the tools we will be using for making the video. And at last, we'll see that when it is ready, how we are going to publish it. Especially if you take the example of webinar, where we are just like in this platform, I'm just trying to throw the content to you. So here I'm not recording anything. It is going online, in online mode. And you are receiving my content directly in the live mode. So here I do not have any option to edit it. If I do not share any content, it may not reach you. But as I said, the content coverage, I have in my mind that what I have to discuss with you so that I do not deviate from my main target, main purpose of this event. So after all this, when we finish everything, we need to see, we need to think, we need to decide that how, means suppose if we record the video or if we just throw the content in online mode. So basically, there are three components involved in the whole culture. I call it as an e-learning culture. And in this e-learning culture, the three components are very, very important. And that is the learner, the content creator who just create the content, and also who provides all the benefits, the administrator. So especially when we talk about the learner point of view, so the video which you are going to create, video which you are going to prepare, you have to ensure that the learner who is going to see, it should motivate the learner. And that is only possible when your coverage, your content is very powerful. If your content is not very powerful, the end user may not like your video and may skip your video and go to the next video. So whenever you are recording, whenever you are just attending any conference or just going to deliver any conference, talk in a conference or seminar, symposia, anywhere, you need to decide that whatever the content I am going to throw, it is going to motivate the user. If the end user is not motivated, and the user is not going to give you much attention. So, and that will discourage you a lot. In that scenario, what you have to do, you need to ensure that you engage the end user, and your content should be engaging one. In between, you can demonstrate, you can also attract the user by showing some of the example. So 3-4 things are very, very important. That the content should be self-directed, I mean user should be in position to direct himself or herself with the content of the video. The content should be so much powerful that the user motivates himself or herself to go ahead without getting irritated or finding not useful, self-regulating, and also it should be the lifelong learning. Suppose today I do not cover this, at least I should be in position to cover it in future. Content creator, basically knowledge manager or who develops the knowledge and skills, understand learning and its needs, facilitate learning, and also create learning opportunities. So whoever is the content creator, there is no limitation that the content creation is limited to only few people. Anyone can create the content. Anyone can create the video and throw it for the general purpose. And the third one, that is the administrator, that is the main responsibility of the administrator, is that administrator is responsible for creating learning environment. This is especially, I'm talking in the sense of educational institutions, or the suppose I'm a content creator, so I'm also acting as an administrator, especially for this event. So I need, or I have to ensure that the platform which I am sharing with you, or the platform which I'm using for creating this content, for delivering the talk. So my responsibility, or the administrator responsibility, is to create the learning environment, provide ICT infrastructure so that whoever, like a teacher or anyone who is making the videos, should be in position to make the video easy. And also resources should be archived or deposited somewhere so that it is preserved for a longer period of time, after 5 years also if I need, or if somebody wants to just refer it, so he or she may use the content without any difficulty. So this also we have to keep in mind. And now the question is that to record the video, how should I start? That is the main important thing in the whole the event. Some of the question you may have in your mind, that where to start, how to record video, and how to prepare the content that really works, and then how to make a video attractive and engaging. All these are very genuine questions you may have in your mind, and how to make content accessible. So these all questions will help you to think that how do I start. So for that only, I have just added some of the points, and I will just immediately after this PPT, I will show you also that how to record, how to edit, and how to make it accessible for the end users. So you will get more familiarity with the topic. Current practices, as you might have experience that we are following, there is a virtual teacher or learner center, centered, or the content creator who creates the content with the help of a computer or the laptop, whatever, and ensures that it is going to be interactive through multimedia in the form of video, animation, or image, or text, graphics, whatever. And it attracts the user and try to engage the user with the content. These are some creating video, the tools for creating the video, or whatever the content we prepare with the help of computer, that is the e-content. So in other sense, you can say that how we can create the e-content for education purpose or for our personal purpose. So these are some software which are very, very powerful, and not all, but most of them are freely available. So that you can use for your purpose. Yeah. And this basically, in the category of content creating tool, there are very good software, that is the Camtasia, Adobe Captivate, Articulate, and MobaVI. Out of all these four, if you go for the Camtasia may be very, very expensive. It is around 23 or 24,000 in Indian currency. So that I will not advise, because if you go for the Camtasia, it may be very costly for you. Similarly, the Adobe Captivate or Articulate, these are also may not be suitable for you. But yes, another software which I have mentioned in the PPT, that is the MobaVI, that is very low cost video editing software, and you can buy it online. I am using it. When I purchased, it was only 1,400 rupees. But now I just saw the price is little bit more. But believe me, this is wonderful software. If you compare with any other software, you'll find it more and more advanced and all the features available in it. So if, especially if you are really just want to make or interested to make the video and edit the video, make it professional type video, so you should definitely go ahead with Mova VI software, which is very, very good software for content creation. Especially the education institute or those who are involved in teaching, and very often they keep conducting the quiz programs. So for them, there is a software iSpring, and that is really very, very nice software. But you may not find it free freely. You have to pay for this. But in addition to this, there are many software which you can use for creating the quiz. And especially those who are teacher, I will personally suggest that you can use Moodle, where inbuilt feature is given. You can also engage the students, teachers, and you can throw the content, and also you can create the quiz, and you can invite them to take part in quiz. But still, if you want the quizzing, the platform or the content presentation in a very effective way, so you should go ahead with the iSpring. The learning platform, the Moodle and Google Classroom, these two are very popular these days. Moodle is basically throughout the world, people like it. Similarly, the Google Classroom also, but in comparison to Moodle, Google Classroom is having less feature, or you can say less content creation options. And other important tool, that is the TED Talk and WiseThread, Khan Academy, all these are also very powerful. Content, having content also provides the person to create the content. These are the tools. I'll just quickly go so that you do not get bored with this. I will directly go to the, you can say, the practical part, so that it is going to be interactive and more friend, interesting for you. See, when we start video making, we also have to ensure that the image, suppose that is not covered in video, so we need to add the video, we need to add the image, we need to cut the image. Some of the portion we have to create manually. So for that you will be needing one software, and for that I find that Adobe Photoshop is a very good software. But if you go for the open source category, in open source category there is a software called GIMP. And that you can install even in the window or even in the Linux. GIMP is very, very powerful. And also it is very just like Adobe Photoshop. And apart from this, there is a software, IrfanView. This IrfanView software is or will help you to edit the image with quickly. Suppose I want to cut some of the portion, or I want to make in the different extensions. It supports more than 20 extension conversion. So IrfanView is a very small utility which will help you to edit the image. And as I mentioned, for video editing tool, there are many tools. And Mova VI is one software which will help you for editing. But yes, when you are creating the content with the help of YouTube or TED or TED Talk or Vimeo, so there also they provide the opportunity to edit. But you will not be getting all the features which you get in the offline software or separately dedicated software. If you compare the editing portion from the YouTube, you may not be comfortable with those tools available in the these tools. So personally, I suggest that if you are really professionally going or thinking that I should make a video, so you go ahead with the Mova VI. Try it, and this is lifetime. You can say the license is given in one-time purchase, so you can go ahead with that. Many times, friends, or we need to make the video online in the animated mode. So for that, there are two very good software, Animoto, and even you can use TED. And apart from that, you can shoot the video from camera. I'll be showing, this is my camera, and this camera basically will help you to record. This is Sony HD camcorder, so I can record the video. I'll show you how to record and everything, and this will have the video recording, and that you can convert, you edit it with the software, and you can just make the video very powerful the way you want. And for screen recording, many times it happens many times it happens that we do not record it, we do not just show our face, we do not just go live. And in that case, sometimes, suppose I am making a content with the help of PPT, so I will use software which can help me to record a screen, and I can convert it in video and I can share with my friend. So for that, a very free software, when I downloaded it, it was free, but I came to know that now they have made it commercial. But it's still, many softwares are there for screen recording, screen capturing. And one of them is APowerSoft, which gives you freedom to record it in the window platform. And in another one, that is the paid software Camtasia, that is more powerful than any other software in my opinion, because it has got a lot of features for editing the video. A communication tool, there are many, I need not to say, we are all familiar with the communication tool, that is WhatsApp, Skype, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, and there are plenty. So you need to decide which one you are going to use for sharing your content when you create. Webinar and online meetings, there are many software, and this video, actually when we think about the video, so we need to see that which software I'm going to use so that I can have a proper connectivity with the participants, with the end users, and they will see my whole content. So there are many, like Adobe Connect, Google Meet, WebEx, Zoom, GoToMeeting, JioMeet, all these, and StreamYard, this is which I'm using right now. StreamYard is undoubtedly very, very good software and very powerful. Only the thing is that it is little bit costly and it does not allow more than 6 people. There are multiple, you can say, many options available in this. So it does not allow you to involve more people in the platform. But if you just think about the feature-wise, you will find this particular, especially for the webinar, where only panelist and host is going to be online through YouTube or any other platform like social media. So in that case, I personally recommend and suggest to use this software, because it allows so many things at the back end. Like you can add the branding, you can add the chat facility, which will be visible in my screen, and I can show it even on the screen, which will be visible to everyone. So these are very powerful, means especially StreamYard is very, very powerful for web conferencing or webinar or engaging the participants with each. And like other Zoom, WebEx, Google Meet is also free and powerful, up to 100 participants. And if you want to go for G Suite, so you can get up to 250. For the Adobe Connect, is also commercial. All these are commercial basically. But some of the free features are given. Some of them are having time limitation now, like WebEx or Zoom. It allows you to set the meeting for 40 minutes or 45 minutes. But you can use it for web conferencing. And here I'll be showing you some good things that, as I mentioned in my topic, that how you can change the background when you just, as you can see in this StreamYard, the background which is available in this live talk, that is not original my video. That is not my original background. At the background, I have something else. But with the help of software and different techniques, I have been using this this one background, and it looks like real, very attractive, and it keeps the whole video in a very attractive way. So that we will discuss after this. There are many other tools also can be used. That is the part of e-content creation, and I'm not going to discuss that one. And for creating content, like where you can share, like WordPress, Blogger, Google site, all these. So I'm skipping this. Basically, it was very related to the video. So I just took some of the portion from my other slide, e-content creation. And from there, I just tried to incorporate them in this webinar, because this is also, video is also e-content. Let me draw your attention that how to create video, how to create e-content. So basically, when I say teacher means whoever is going to just throw the video on platform, so he or she will be responsible or can be a teacher Especially, let's take the example of YouTube. So there we need to prepare the video, we need to prepare, upload the lecture, and after that we have to engage the end user. We can say obviously it's a student or anyone who is going to watch the video, and we have to reach to the maximum student. So the student interaction is very, very important, especially those who are going to throw the content on YouTube. And in that case, you need to decide or you need to ensure some of the things, especially when, see, these days we have a lot of, you can say, hardware available. Which allows you to record video in through different methods, and undoubtedly smartphone has really created an opportunity for everyone to record the video, to just prepare the content and share with the end users. And I take the example of one smartphone. I also have the other two, like as I told. I just showed you the camcorder, or you can even use your own camera of good quality, like a Logitech or any other good quality camera. So the five areas you have to look into, that is the stability, that is very, very important. When you record the video, your camera should not shake, because if it is going to shake, you are going to have the shaking video, which may the user or participants, they may not like. You need to see the proper lighting arrangement, and because if you are making video and it does not have the proper lighting, a lot proper audio, proper lens, so these all will create you can say will not give a good quality video. So you need to think about all this, and some of the hardware I will show you now. Because after this, we will immediately discuss about the practical. But these some hardware you will require for making your video stable, and especially to have some, you can say, good quality video. So you can see some of the pictures I have listed there. But this is also one tripod which I have been using. For attaching my video, or sometimes I use it for camcorder. So this gives me the freedom that I do not have to worry about the stability of the video. And likewise, I have another one which I have fixed. I will show you for that I use for light purpose. So this basically here I have the freedom. I do not worry about, because I can add my camera. I can add even the virtual camera, this one, the another camera, I can fix it. And then I just get free from the taking part. So my video gets stable. The second point that is important, the tripod, you can buy this tripod from Amazon or Flipkart. There it is easily available for 500 or 600 rupees. And you don't have to buy a very good quality one, which cost more than 30 or 40,000 or sometimes in lakhs. I don't think that you require that. Second one, that is the lighting. That is important one. And for that, I have personally, I will recommend personally that you just buy these days through different platform. You can buy and it is available. So I'll just show you, give me 1 minute. See, this is the camera, this is lighting, for lighting purpose I'm using this. And this basically I have purchased for 400 rupees. It is fixed with the tripod. And when I attach it to USB, just I attach to USB. So here I have one controller which allows me to just see, this is the, it keeps the lighting very in a nice way. And there are multiple, you can say, the variations, the white, yellow, or light yellow, And if I don't want too much light, so I can dim it, it will just go down. Even I can just increase it. So I have this this facility which keeps the lighting proper on my face, and it does not create it does not create the blur, or it does not create the quality regulation problem. And it is very, very the good tool. And also I will show you here also in this, nowadays it is coming, you can fix your camera here. This also you can do. So light and camera both can be fixed in the same this lighting tool, and this will help you to get the stability. If you are not having this, you can also just keep yourself in front of the area where you have sufficient light, the natural light. So that will give you a lot of stability in your camera and the resolution. Now coming to the phone part, microphone. So I am basically using this. I bought it for 660 rupees, and so far I think I have bought more than 10 headphone or earphone, and none of them I found very stable, or you can say very good. But this basically I got it for 660 rupees of Boat company, and this is very good. It gives a lot of comfort while talking. And I can just, you can see, I can fold it like this and I can keep. So it is very handy also. It is easy to use. And I can rotate. See, sometimes we need just like this. So you see, I can just keep the headphone like this. I can keep in my bag if I'm traveling. And this is not very costly, and it is giving me a very good result. So I will personally suggest that if you don't want to go for the higher version, if you don't want to go for the higher quality camera, so you can see my recorder is also here. So it catches my voice and it gives a good quality, the sound. So personally, I will suggest that if you are really interested to make the video professional type, so you can use this. There is nothing wrong in that. But I have another, this one. See this, this one, basically, this is the condenser mic I have been using. And this condenser mic, basically, the question answer, I'll give all the questions answer. I'll just give at the last of the session. You can keep typing the question and I'll discuss. This is the condenser mic, which I purchased for, this is BM800. And this is very, very good quality condenser mic. The beauty of this condenser mic is that it does not attract the sound of fan. It does not attract, suppose the fan is on, and or if somebody is talking in the area of 3 or 4 feet, so it will not attract the sound. And you can just add the cover on that, so you will have more noise clarity, and this is very powerful. So what I have done, I just this is also one kind of tripod which is fixed to my table. You see this portion, I just fix it here. And after fixing on my table, I can stretch it up to 1 meter. And you can see, I just fix my this mic here, and I can keep like this. So it just collects the input, and it will just transfer to my laptop. So that will give me the good quality video, especially when I have to record any offline videos. I just use it this. But when I got this Boat, I found it very, very useful. So most of the work I do with this, but still I'm using this. I have two, I have one of the T series. Here also it is, I can just remove it and I can use it for recording or live session. So there are multiple types, but I will suggest that if you're going for the condenser mic, so you should go ahead with the BM800. It is good quality, though it is little bit costly, around 5,000 or 6,000 rupees. But yes, you will get quality. You will not disappoint. And if you want to make yourself free, you can also buy the collar mic from Ahuja. That may also cost around 5,000 to 6,000 rupees, where you can fix the tools and you can fix in your collar. So that also you can use. But I personally suggest that you don't go for that, because sometimes I have found that if the collar mic is not of good quality or not great, good brand quality, then you will not have that powerful sound, and unnecessarily it will be the wastage of money. So you can go ahead with this normal one, which I showed you. This is the Boat company, and model number, everything I'll just add in the at the end of the session. So that will give you the you can say clear cut idea that how you can use it. And these are additional parts, like you may require some other small things to connect the computer. So for that you will require the small thing. These are all not very important. If you do not have, then also it will give you stability. As my this camera, this mic is fixed here, so I have one tool which gives me freedom to rotate my mic wherever I want. So it is up to you that how you are going to just keep all these things in a row. This is my live video, it's a YouTube channel, that is Librarian Guide, where I am adding the content on regular basis. And this is my website, dptripathi.co.in. So whatever the content I create, whether it is text or online, I just add. And these are some software. You can quickly just have a look. I'm not going to discuss this browser, and these are all open source in nature, which will be helpful for you to manage the content or for general purpose. So this you can see in the video later also. And now I'm coming to the important portion, that is the most popular digital tool for creating the video, that is the TED-Ed, where you can discover the video, and also you can create, and a student can create, or whoever is a teacher or educator can create, or sometimes the parents can start here. So this is also a very good platform. And Animoto, the Animoto is very, very, you can say, powerful and easy to use. You don't have to bother about any editing or anything. Some of the means you can, initially you can start with the free, you can say, free setting. You just go to Animoto and simply sign up and choose the template. Thousands of freely templates for different occasions have been given, like explainer, holiday list, motivational video, how to create the quiz video, or whatever the type you are looking for, you will get on this Animoto site. Or there are many, but I will not suggest you to go for searching the tools in a sea. One you choose, once your idea is clear, then you can start making your own video. You can start searching for another one, but Animoto is a very good one, which gives you our opportunity to make the animated video kind, where the cartoons are there, the voiceover facility will be there, and all these you can do in this platform. So you can choose if you are interested to make the animated video. And this is my personal belief, that you don't have to live like an ancient pro. Now we have to become a smart and modern crow. The difference between these three is that ancient crow used to throw the pebble in the pot to make the level, water level up, so that he can drink. Later the time changed and the crow became old crow and started using straw to drink water. But now the time has changed. We need to develop our skill in such a way that we can sit on the chair and we can drink water with such straw, which is having the flexibility. So the flexibility will get developed only when you want, you will push yourself in order to learn all this. So I stop my sharing of the screen here, and now I will just show you. This is the Warren Buffett, one very famous quote: the best investment you can make is an investment in yourself. The more you learn, the more you will earn. So now I'll be taking you directly to the live session where I will show you some of the video, and after that I will show you that how we can record. So first I am going to show you the video or the live conferencing video. And basically you all know that in the video we don't have to do anything in that video. Only I am just going to show that suppose you are using any live video or you are going to deliver talk, so how will you change the background and what are the requirements or what are the things you require in order to change the background so that your video will look nice and also it will have a better quality or attractive video. So let me log in with my Zoom. This is web conferencing tool, and this is some security question. It's coming. Yeah, it has come now. So okay, let me just open the meeting here. I will just open one meeting. Suppose I schedule a meeting and I just start it. Okay, I did not share my screen, so I'll share it first. Yeah. Yes, so I think it is visible now. So this, I'm in the Zoom platform, and here in Zoom platform, I will start this meeting. Once I start this meeting, so after starting, it will open the Zoom. It initially takes some time. If Zoom is not installed, so it may take little time to bring your video conferencing page. Suddenly it is connecting and it will be just, yeah. So now I'm inside my Zoom where I can see that my video is off, and I'll open the video. Just let me open the video. Okay, my camera is being this one shared by another one, so it may not allow me because the camera is being shared. So what I can do, I can use this another camera, and I will then show you. So I am using this camera, and you can see at the background I'm having some picture. This is not my the real background. And how did I change it? There is a option in Zoom. I just go to the choose background. And in the background, I have lot of pictures. You see here, I have so many pictures, even I can choose none. So when I say none, you can see at the background that I have the screen background. And this is called green screen effect. So this green effect has, the software has the ability that it can clear that green screen. And that green screen, if I clear and add the image, so in that way, my image gets changed. So you can see right now, I have not selected any image. So the original background is my green, and it is coming green. But now in the background and filler, if I choose the particular image, so you can see it is changed. It has changed. Only the thing is that you need to ensure that proper green screen should, green background should be there. Otherwise, it will create blur and it will not give you the good quality. So if I choose the proper green background and then it will give me the good quality, or it will not have the blur, and it will allow me to change it also. You see, when I choose the picture, anyone, anything, it is changing the background. So I wanted to give you the proper the idea how you can do this. So this particularly, especially when you are using any web conferencing tool, whether Google Meet or the WebEx or anything, you can use this. But the question is here that you may not have the facility of virtual background in all the software. And it is not possible in all software. Like Zoom, in Zoom, especially when you use Zoom, you can use commercial version of software where you can have the background changing option. But if you don't want, if you're not comfortable, because you may not have this facility in all the web conferencing, so for that, I personally recommend that you can use the very good software, that is the X Split VCam, and is not very costly. You can buy it for $9 for 3 months, so almost $3, 201 rupees in a month it will come across. That will convert, that will give you the, suppose I take the X Split camera here, so that xsplit.com VCam, that will give you more clarity. The feature that you can have the background, the green screen, and you can convert, you can add the image, whatever the image you want, and this you can use for your purpose. So this is very good software, and in that case, this X Split you can use in any web conferencing, whether it is Zoom or whether it is WebEx, whether that software has facility or not. So this X Split VCam will directly convert your video camera, the background. 1 minute, I'll show you this. You see, this is the X-Split. The camera actually I'm using, so I'll change this camera so it will be visible now. So now I'm using the camera of my laptop. So the another camera is giving the view the input output from the different camera. This is my laptop camera. So you can see the background, I can change whatever I want. It is completely in my hand. And this I'm using the X Split software. So this will give me original background is my green, you see. But if I want to change it, I can change the any background the way I want. Only you need to ensure that the background, the green background which you are setting, it should be very, you can say, bright. Means there should not be any darkness on the backside. If there is a darkness, so that will not give you the more clarity, and also you will face the problem of, you can see in my image, there are patches and it's blur continuously occurring. So all these you can avoid only by having the proper lighting on the your screen. So that will give you the more clarity if you have the proper green background, and then you can add with the help of X Split. So these are all you can use this X Split in any kind of software, virtual software, virtual conferencing software, and that virtual conferencing software will allow to use X Split, because X Split is the third software which you are only using to convert your video with the added background. So in the online mode, you can do like this. And similarly, you can do in the StreamYard. But in the StreamYard, you have a very good facility of inbuilt green effect or green background. So if you have a green background in StreamYard, so directly it will convert. You don't need any other third-party software or third software which will convert your or allow you to add the background. So this is up to you which one you are going to use. Now I am going to show you that how we can record the offline video, and that we can change to that we can change that there we can change the background and also we can edit. So the video you can record either through your webcam, your laptop camera, or you can even use the camcorder. Camcorder, if you're using with the camcorder, that video will come separately, which you need to carry, means to bring, just transfer from your camera to your computer or laptop, and there you need to modify the whole content. And you have the freedom to edit that one, so that wherever you want to add the text, wherever you want to add the or cut the particular portion. So all these you can do after recording with the software. So as I mentioned that I am using the Mova VI software. Mova VI software is very, very powerful, as I already mentioned. So I have already recorded one video, and I will just show you that how to use that one. So this is my software, that Mova V software, Mova V Video Editor Plus. This is the licensed version. You can also buy it comes around in between 2000 to 3000 rupees, and it has all the features. So for any kind of video editing purpose, you can use this. And you can see that left side there are options, right side it will show you the video, and below there are tracks where you can add the track, remove the track. Now I'm going to show you to add one video with the background. So in order to have the background, first you need to add the background. So for example, I have downloaded one background. This is my original background, which I'm using this. I'll be using this background. And also I have one video, which I have downloaded with screen background. Since my background is not clear, here I recorded, it is not having proper light. What I did, I simply downloaded one video from internet, which is having the screen green. And that I will be using to demonstrate you that how we can clear the green. So you see, I have added one image here at the background, you can see in the video. And this is my real video. So what I do, I just double click on this. So it gets selected, and I can just drag it, and I can keep up to here. I just select the portion where I want to keep. Now up to here I have done. Now there is a, in this software, there is a option of chroma effect. So this chroma key will allow you to remove the green background. And the moment I select this video and apply, now you see the curtain is coming over the background, which I'm using at the behind the curtain. So now you see how does it play. When I play the video, now it will look like this. Green screen will not appear, only it will open the curtain. So similarly, if I record my own video having the green background, only my face and my whatever the body, it will appear, and all the background just which is having with the green screen will be cleared. So this will give you opportunity to record and add the image at the background. Now you see once again, this video earlier it had the green background, means at the backside green, but I just use the chroma key. So the background, I use this particular screen, and on the top of that I use this one. So it is opening the curtain. So this is, you can say, the video editing, where you can add the video and you can whatever you want to do. So this is also one method through which you can just add the image at the background or in the video. This is offline editing, you can say. Here you have got more flexibility, you got more freedom to edit the video. Now I am just going to show you another important software which you can use for recording the screen, and that is the APowerSoft. As I already mentioned, this is the APowerSoft free screen recorder. Like this, there are many software. For example, if you talk about Linux, in Linux there is a simple screen recorder. In Windows, this is APowerSoft, or even you can use the Movie Maker, which comes freely with the Windows operating system. I don't know these days whether it is available or not. But I remember till means 2003 or 4, it was there. I never used that one because it has less feature, but still it can be used. And so what are the facility you have here? You see in the A-Power FreeSoft, suppose I have to record the full screen. So what I will do, I'll just click full screen and I'll click OK. So it will ask you just 1, 2, 3, and now the starting starts. Once they start in recording has started, whatever I do on the screen, whatever I play here and there, it will get recorded and that will convert into the video. So you see my video has already recorded and now I stop it and this will convert into MP4 and then this video I can drag to the mobile V editor. There I can cut that portion which is not essential or some of the portion is missing, so I can record another video. I can add in between, I can edit it not properly, and then I can just compile all of them. See, this is the video which we recorded. Now I'm going to just play it. So this video will play. Once I started, you see, whatever I have done, it has been recorded.
Recording has
been and
started.
Now it is showing.
Whatever I do on the screen, whatever I play here and there, it will get recorded and that will convert into the video. So you see, my video has already recorded. Now I stop.
So in this way, you can record the video with a screen recorder. So whatever you are doing in your computer, whatever you're doing in your laptop, it will get recorded and it will, you can edit it later when you want. So this is the method to record in the offline mode, and this is the site A-PowerSoft where you can get another product for multimedia, mobile, utility, online. All these are the software from A-PowerSoft, and I find it very, even if I have to pay, I will pay this and buy it, because this particular software I get and I use, and it is very, very useful for my different purposes. So especially for my all video content or video editing I do, I find this A-PowerSoft is very, very powerful. So I hope I have been able to give you enough the content or enough idea that how you can start with the making the video, editing the video, and also adding the image. And let us go back to the this one is studio, and now we will see that what are the questions raised by the friends, and then I'll answer. So my this submission is that whatever we do, first we have to prepare the overview, that what I'm going to talk, and that is important, and then what I'm going to cover in that, for whom I'm going to make the video, how I'm going to do, how I'm recording, that is not a big deal. Only the thing is that if you do not give the proper and powerful content to the audience, that is not going to receive a good number of you can say view. So people may not like it. Sometimes they will discourage to see the same video again. So my advice is that those who are really interested to make the video, they just think about the topic, think about the content, and then start making the video. Then it will have the good impact on your participants. So some of the questions, let me take up quickly. Dr. G. Stephen, he has written great and new tools, sir. Those are really economical. Kindly list out those tools, name, model in description box. I hope this helps to all. Okay, Dr. Stephen, thank you very much for your kind words. I'll definitely prepare the list of all the software which are involved in making the video, editing the video, and also publishing it publicly. So I will just definitely do that. And I'll share with you all. And the next question is from Kulvinder Singh. Good afternoon, sir. Can you please also suggest some free or open source software, video editing software? OpenShot is there. Filmora is not a free software for Windows.
Filmora Go is there for Android. DaVinci Resolve. See, there are many software, especially for video editing. OpenShot you can use. This is good software. But when you compare the feature-wise, I find very difficult to name any particular software, especially for video editing. Because if you have the commercial software, you get a lot of additional feature in that. And that gives you opportunity to enhance your quality of video, enhance your video quality. And also it enhances your, you can say, addition of so many other points in that. So my suggestion is not to use, but you can go ahead with the OpenShot. It is not this one. A bad software. It also provides a lot of facility. Since I have been using Mova VI, so I like it very much because I have been comfortable with it. But you may be comfortable with OpenShot or Filmora. Filmora also I have used, but that is not free. That is costly one, around $300 it costs. So that may be a little bit costly. But still, if you want to use Filmora, you can use it, but it will have the brand name of that on the top of your video. So it is up to you how you are going to use it. Next question is from Mr. Ayan Mandal, my brother. Is it possible to change the screen in Zoom while using it through browser? Yes, it is possible. In the browser only, I showed you that in laptop, you install Zoom and you open the video in Zoom. And there is, when you start there, you can use change my virtual image. Ensure that you have a proper green background at the backside, and it will ask you to add the image. You just add it. It will look like the my, you can say behind my, behind me there is a lap. This one green screen, but it is showing the image. So this way you can also do, Mr. Ayan. Okay, how to remove background without using green screen? There are other software which allows, but I tried my level best to remove. I do not find software because Chroma key facility is important. Some of the software for removing the background, I will name them. You can just try. Some of them like Final Cut Pro, Camtasia also supports, and then Video Steel. You can note down. Video Steel, this is also a good software. Unscreen, that is the online editing. Mova VI, I have already told. Chroma Vid, these are all background remover. But I don't think without green screen, they will be able to do it. But you try. VSDC Video Editor, I did not find any software. I do not find any software which has removing facility without green screen. Kulvinder Singh, I hope I have been able to answer your question. Kulvinder Singh is asking, sir, how had you made visible the comment on the screen? This is the magic of software, dear. Sorry, Mr. Kulvinder. This StreamYard, there is a web conferencing tool I am using. So whatever comment you are just commenting on YouTube, you can see my screen, you can, whatever, I can see that whatever comment you are giving. So the moment I just see your comment, I just drag it and bring it to the screen. So your comment appears on my screen. So in this way, I'm just displaying the comment, whatever I get from the YouTube. So I hope I have been able to make you understand that how to make the video, how to edit it with the different software, and how to add the image at the in the video as a background, and how to publish it. So my effort has been to make you understand. I hope you all understood, you liked it, and also I will be happy to receive your comment through. I am just sharing one link, and I will request all of you just give comment, honest comment, so that next time whenever we meet, I'll just try to add the your suggested point. So in that way, we can make the video more useful. And Okay, so thank you very much for joining this event. I hope you all will just keep suggesting and keep motivating, and we will come once again. I'll come with new video which will be helpful to you all, and also I'll get an opportunity to interact with you all. So wishing you all a very happy Dasara once again. Please stay happy, stay safe, and take care of your family. Thank you all.